iDVD is a registered trademark of Apple Computer. I am in no way affiliated with Apple Computer. In this clip, we're going to be adding a slideshow to our project. If you remember in our iMovie tutorial, we created a little slideshow in iMovie of our Atlantic City photos. And this movie is here in our media browser. You can see it up here. Now, I can simply drag this movie to our project, and our slideshow will be intact as it was exported from iMovie. But iDVD also gives you a very quick and easy way to create a slideshow directly in iDVD. So I'm going to show you how to do that now. In the bottom left-hand corner, you see a plus button. This is your Add button. You want to click on that and hit Add Slideshow. You see a button appear in your menu that says My Slideshow. I'm going to leave this like this is for now. What you want to do is double-click it, and this brings up your slideshow editor window. Now over here, it automatically selects your Photos folder, and it'll show you anything that's in your iPhotos application. You can see our Atlantic City photos here. Let's double-click on that. And we see all our Atlantic City photos that we used in iMovie. So what we want to do is just hold our mouse button down and drag to select all of these, and drag them over to the project window. And they appear in your editor window. Now down here, we can also, in the left-hand corner, you can see where it says Transition. We want to choose our nice dissolve transition. And there's also a little speaker icon here. This indicates audio. When this is grayed out like this, there's no audio in our project. Let's add some audio. In the top right-hand corner, we click our audio button. And we want to use the search feature to search Acoustic Dreams. We've used this in our iMovie project before. And just drag it over. You see the little green plus circle right over the speaker icon here. Now we have some audio for our slideshow. Now, one thing that happens when you add audio is your slide duration automatically changes so it fits to the audio. We don't want to really do that in this clip because the audio is much, much longer than the number of slides that we have. So we're going to reset this back to a nice 3-second duration. Now, if we want to see what this looks like, we come down here where the little play button is. This is our preview button. Hit play and we'll start watching our slideshow. Now you notice that when you hit play, a little remote control icon appears up in the right hand corner. This gives you VCI controls so you can navigate to your preview. Okay, that looks good. So we want to go to our remote control here and hit exit. Brings us back to our slideshow editor. And once we're satisfied with our slideshow, we just hit return to return to our regular menu. Now the final thing I want to do is change this button so it looks like this button. I want to click on it, let's delete those words, and let's name it Play Honeymoon. And we also want to change the font here to Gill Sands, like our other one. And we also want to change the color, so let's hit Command-I to open up our button info window. Hit our little color wheel, grab our magnifying glass, go over the brown text of the main menu, select that. And we want to add our shadow to match the Play Wedding button as well. And the final thing we want to do is just move it into position. So you just want to click on it, and we can move it anywhere. This little yellow line appears to help you align buttons. It'll either appear on the top or the left or the right. And it's a nice tool to help you make sure that they're on the same plane. Now, you see this red outline here. This indicates your title safe areas. You don't want to really move anything out of these areas because then you run the risk that on certain televisions they'll be cropped out. So you want to make sure that all your important text appears within this red outlined box. Okay, that looks good.